What is up, guys? Darkdally here, and today we are actually going to continue back on the castle with remodeling the helipad because I found the inspiration I needed to continue doing it. I didn't know what I was gonna do with it, but now I do. I have a couple tricks I want to show you. First, I'm gonna show you how I did them, and then we're gonna go to the helipad. And I will have a sped up process of me building it, but first I want to show these in their completion so that you can see how it's done. So first of all, this is something I just thought of this morning. Inspiration struck me. We're gonna have a suspension bridge out to it. This was very simple to build. It was just a concrete eighth wall with a conduit on top, and then I just stretched wires down here. It's pretty self-explanatory. The only tricky thing I did on this was I used the wires through walls glitch to connect some of these to that conduit. I will have a link either on the screen or in the description to my wires through walls glitch video to show you how to do it. It's very simple to do. The other thing that I want to show you that's going to be featured in my helipad is the lighting for it. At first I wanted to use these light boxes, but the problem with these is they can only face one way. You can't snap another one to it 90 degrees to face the other way, blah blah blah. And here is where I was experimenting with them, and then I came up with this idea. This is how we're gonna light the helipad. You will see it, and first I'm gonna show you, like the suspension bridge, how it's done, so that when you see it you'll be like, you already know how I did it. The way I got these lights here was actually very simple. I just built a concrete wall. Let's go into build mode. I built a concrete wall. I attached lights to it. I deleted the concrete wall. Now, if you notice, some of the lights disappeared with it. The reason some of the lights disappeared with it is because they were snapped and thus clamped to it. But these remaining lights existed, and you can still use these as a point to snap off of. So all you need is, you know, one or two lights remaining, and you can still snap off of them and create this cool little dealy here. Now, if I were to grab these lights, I can't grab these because it would grab everything else around it. So I will show you over here. Oh my gosh, I lost them. Here we go. If I were to grab these, I can't move them because now they have nothing to snap to. So you need to make sure they are on the pole at ground level when you delete them, and then they'll be left kicking it there just like this. Trust me, it's gonna look cool, guys. Now there's one more trick I want to show you. This kind of relates to this lighting thing and a little bit of everything else. It's something that I just figured out. Let's go ahead and put a pole back up. There's several poles you can use. I've used fence poles, but honestly, these new concrete eighth walls work excellent for anything you want to mount onto a pole. I had these mounted on here, and as you saw, I deleted it. There's one other way you can do this, and that is to create the lights elsewhere and move them onto the pole. Now, as you know, when you grab objects, it tries to grab everything else around the objects, and that can be frustrating. So what we're going to do is we're going to go to this building here, which is pre-existing on Spectacle Island. I didn't build it, and there's nothing that I built near it, which means I could, if I were to have items attached to it, grab them and then move them. So you can also create the lights, say, here. The same lights I just use I and H to make this little light rail dealy. And now I can grab these by holding X as a group off of that and safely move them onto this pole. Like so. And then delete the pole. And so I have, and of course that H disappeared. It's because it was clamped to the pole. Again, we can just put it back like so. Okay, so we'll put one there, then we'll snap one beside it. I mean, you can see how it works. And then to make it blink, it's a very simple matter of, I have a lot of complicated shit here. It's because I was testing with different lights. Let's disconnect this, and I'll show you how you can... let's disconnect this wire. Turns off all those lights. And this should still, oh, it will still be blinking. Let's move this pylon closer. This is just a matter of having a blinking power grid, because these run off a power grid and not individual power like these lights do. This is just a matter of having your grid blink, which is what I have here. I have a generator going to a terminal, which I have set to a particular interval for this interval switch, and it makes the power grid blink. You just got to make sure, if you're going to have a blinking power grid, that it's away from everything else. Let's run over here. Oh my gosh, run. There we go. And I'm able to do that here because my helipad, this is how it looks now. Tonight it will be sweet. Is far enough away from a house that it can have its own grid, which won't affect this, and can blink on and off. So now I've given you a little preview of what we're gonna do, and you see how I'm gonna, you know, what I'm gonna do and how I'm gonna do it. We're gonna have the suspension bridge. I got awesome ideas for lighting over here for the helipad, because you gotta have blinking lights on a helipad. That's what we're gonna do. Guys, I'll see you in a second. All right, and here we are in the sped up and much abbreviated version of where I actually built this. Took me a couple of hours, and going back through the footage, I tried speeding it up more. Right now it's sped up 2 times. I actually tried speeding it up more, but it was about to give me a seizure. So this is about as much as you can speed it up without going into shock from all the flashing images. And I had to cut a lot of sections out too, because I simply just spent a couple hours doing this. Now what I'm doing right here is I decided to use my staircase support beams to support the new helipad. I showed you the old helipad, and it was just a platform and a pillar. I didn't like that. I wanted to do this. And here I actually used the staircases way easier and better than I ever have before. Instead of trying to snap them to the floor, as you can see, I'm just placing them on the floor, not allowing them to snap, and I'm clipping them down into the floor as far as I can here. You'll see me place another one here. You'll see I'm trying not to let it snap. What am I doing now? Oh yeah, I'm getting rid of that floor. I'm getting that out of the way. I'm trying not to let the stairs snap. I'm not giving them opportunity to, and I'm placing them as far down in the floor as I can so to allow the floor above them to fit better without having to like triple layer it. And this creates a pretty cool look, because here, and because I'm not snapping them, I'm placing them at like, you know, circular angles, and it's going to look pretty cool. Boy, I had a lot of crap going on here. I had platforms everywhere. It gets worse too. I end up with like 3 levels of platforms at one point. I probably cut some of that out, but yeah. And the whole point is just to create a nice good helipad. I want the platform supported. I'm gonna sit here for a second until I can find something else worthy of commentating on, except we see, yeah, right here. Now I'm trying to get the floor above the stairs, and it wants to snap to them, of course, and I want to put it above. So I use my rug trick, and if I recall, this does work and allows me to put a floor above them. Yeah, lets me snap the floor there. It really picks up once I get past this point. This is always the hard part when you're building a structure. If you're doing some kind of support structure to build it up, you know, to hold it up, this is always a slow part, because this is the crap that can't be snapped. You gotta place floors on floors and try to line them up. And then once I get this basic floor laid, then I can start snapping stuff. Oh my God, I make so many trips back through my house. You'll see me fall off a lot. I mean, well, let's be honest, there's a lot of stuff to fall off of here. I've gone through this video extensively to cut out all the stuff that doesn't need to be on screen. I probably could have cut some of this out, but this is good because since my video showing how to do the staircase supports, I found a much better way to do it. Really, I'm really excited for a lot of the things that I've done here, because this helipad, I'll tell you right now, spoiler, it ends up looking awesome. And right now, at this point, I'm, you know, obviously I'm just commentating on this stuff that's happening here. So as I'm speaking right now, it's mostly done. There's some things I need to go back and fix. There's some, mostly lighting issues. I need to move some conduits around, and I'll explain why here in a second. But I will tell you that this ends up looking pretty damn awesome. But man, I spent forever fucking around with these floors, didn't I? And then, of course, there's the problem of, see, I got these... I wish the half-concrete floors looked like the full-concrete floors. See, you know, the half ones are metal and the full ones are concrete. I really wish they made them more uniform, because I have to actually spend some time cleaning this up and rearranging it so that it doesn't look so spotty with, like, you know, gray floors here and dark gray floors there and whatnot. And right there... I spent quite a bit of time connecting this to the building, and that video I actually cut out because it was pointless and it was long. It was a long process actually connecting this to the building. And basically what I did, and you'll see it, it's a couple clips ahead. When I start doing the wiring, you'll just suddenly see there's a floor attaching a bridge or whatever, attaching the helipad to the actual building. And I basically used the same technique as the spiral staircase that I showed in a previous video. Is how I did it, because this helipad is built at an angle that does not coincide with the building, nor does its height. What am I doing now? I take apart part of the floor? I think here I'm trying to figure out exactly, yeah, this is where I'm starting to figure out how the fuck am I going to attach this to the building. It all becomes clear though. We're about to move to the next clip here in a second. It'll skip ahead a bit. Okay. And maybe not a second, maybe more like a minute. I seriously, guys, I spent like all day doing this crap. I called in sick to work today, and because, well, I'm under the weather, but that didn't stop me from building. I love building in this game. If I'm feeling shitty or whatever, no matter how I'm feeling, I'm always in the mood to build. It's just so much fun. I'm glad I finally got this floor like going in and snapping now, because it's been a while fucking around with multiple layers until finally, see that staircase? Okay, I had to take apart part of the floor because the staircase has to move down just like a pixel. And I skipped past that part, but I did. Now here, I decided just having the stairs wasn't enough. I wanted something in the center. So I jumped down to the level where I had the stairs here. And what I'm doing is I'm using the generous clipping abilities allowed by concrete walls to build a cylindrical tower to hold up the platform along with the stairs. It's so awesome that it let me do this. And these walls, you will see, clip straight the fuck through these stairs. They're really generous with these. They let me clip them right through the stairs. It's finally starting to look nice. I'm glad it let me do that, because I built the base for the foundation, then I built the stairs, and then when I started building the floor, that's when I realized, oh shit, I forgot to have something actually holding it up other than just the stair supports. And so I had to tear off part of the floor and go down, and I decided to build that round tower, and I'm glad it worked. Also, that tower, you will see in a few minutes, serves another purpose, because I want to have my helipad lit, and I want to use the flashing power grid that I showed earlier, which is going to require a terminal and interval pylon and shit like that. And that little circular tower right there, allows me to conceal all that crap down in there, and I wire it up with the walls through with the wires through walls glitch. I'm able to run wires straight through the side of that cylindrical wall and hide the electronics, you'll see, inside of it. So now I'm just putting the floor back, trying to keep it as uniform as I can, you know, the gray pieces in the middle with the metal pieces around the outside. It really is a shame they're different colors. Okay, now it's starting to look good, but there's a gap under it. You can see the stairs don't quite touch it, and so I'm gonna go back here in a second and fix that, and I don't remember if that clip is here where I do that. If it's not here, I'll tell you what I did. You can, if you look closely, you can see, yeah, right there, you can see gaps. Stairs don't touch the floor. And what I do is I take part of the floor off. I snap a piece of floor to the stairs, and it allows me to create another level below it. What I do is I create, like I did in an earlier video, if you saw my earlier video where I did the double layer balcony, that's what I did here, is I made this helipad double layer. It hides where the stairs connect, and it gives it that extra thickness. I'm not sure if it's actually in this video, but there's a fairly long clip coming up, so maybe I did. Let's see, what is the next clip? Okay, here, okay. Apparently, I might have skipped that, because here what I'm doing now is I'm building the suspension part. I showed you the suspension bridge idea I had earlier, and now I'm implementing that. I think it's kind of a cool thing. I'm using the conduits and these concrete posts to make, yeah, supports with wires. I know it's not necessary, but I like it to look like stuff's being held up. I mean, obviously that's a large, that's a big theme you see throughout this building here, is everything looks supported even though it doesn't need to be to actually work in the game. Here you're going to see me make really quick use of the wires through walls glitch. It's really easy to use, guys. I connect those two conduits right there so that I have a pilot wire so that I can connect that wire through the post. And then I do the same thing with this one, and then I can delete that little pilot wire down there. And you'll see right here, I'll remove it, and then I move to the next one. Once you get the hang of it, the wires through walls is super easy to do, and allows you to do a lot of really cool stuff. I originally had these posts holding the wires next to the building, and I cut that clip out just because I was pressed for time, and it looked crappy. It looked like just a bunch of wires coming out of the building to the platform. That's why I moved those posts back onto the platform where they are at the base of the steps. Oh yeah, speaking of steps, yeah, I mentioned that I skipped the part where I showed how I connected the helipad to the building, and there it is. You saw it there and there it is, you see it again. I cut that section out because it's just the same process I used to make the spiral stairs. You know, it's just putting down a floor and then putting on an offset floor on top of it, and so on and so forth. It took some work to connect it to the building. I had to use a rug to cover a gap, but shit like that happens sometimes. You know, stuff gets dirty and you have to cover up a gap on the floor with a rug or something like that. I wish I could have sped this up 3 times, but I'm on PlayStation. I have limited video editing capabilities, so, you know, it's all good. And here I start doing the railing. Now, I know beforehand, right off the bat, none of this railing is going to snap. Luckily, these metal railings don't have to snap. They're really liberal with where they allow you to put them. And so I wasn't worried at all going into this railing part. It was just a matter of finding the right size and length railing to put in each place is the only thing. Yeah, I really wanted to put that railing there, but it just wouldn't let me. I forget what I ended up doing there. Is that what I did? And then, yeah, I gave up there. There's no way a railing is going to go there. And then the rest was easy. I was able to take the little three-piece ones like that right there and just snap them all the way around. These are awesome. These railings are a godsend. And then for the corners, easy enough. It took me 2 seconds to figure out I could just put a curved one in there. It won't snap, of course. This curved railing only snaps on top of walls, it seems. And that goes, the same goes with, well, all the railings that just have the one rail. They really only snap on top of walls. But luckily, again, you know, you don't have to snap them. So now we got the railing up. I'm not sure if I, let's see here. Did I skip the part? Okay, it's, I still haven't shown it yet. See, yeah, you can see the gap under the platform where the stairs hit it. This right here. Sorry, guys, it cut me off there. PlayStation has a recording limit of 15 minutes. This is where I decided to start putting the floor under it, and actually, I guess I did cut that section out, but I already explained what I did. I snapped the floor to the stairs and used that to be able to create a double layer floor. I can make a video showing you how to make double layer floors. It's a really awesome thing to strengthen the look of a structure. Now what I'm doing is I'm actually connecting power. I need to run power out to it. Well, at first I decided to run power out to it. I quickly decided then this needs to be on its own separate grid, and that's when I decided, okay, let's just put a generator down there. Even though I have a fusion generator that puts out 100 power, I eventually do decide just to put a tiny generator down in there along with this terminal and run this whole thing completely independently. It's just the best way for it to work. So I put a terminal down there, and I put an interval switch pylon, and I will end up putting a small generator too. See, at first I'm running this wire down there from the building, but it looks bad because of the wires that hold the suspension bridge part of it. That wire, to me, just makes it look confusing. So I do eventually decide, and I probably cut this part out, I decide to take that wire out and run the grid for the helipad completely independently. And oh my god, I think I cut all of them out. All of the times it fell down in that fucking tower. I kept doing it. I did it like 6 times. Like right here, you see me jump down there? I kept falling down there. And the only way out is the fast travel, unless I want to take one of those walls out, and god forbid I take one of those walls out and then it won't snap back into place. So yeah, I keep having to fast travel to get back out. Now here, I'm doing the lights that I showed in the first part of the video. And I cut the first three out, two or three. I'm just showing like the last one here, so you can see how I do it. But I already showed you how I did it. So you know that I attached the lights to the pole, and then I would come over here to a pre-existing wall that I didn't, you know, that did not build. And yeah, then pull the group over there, and I just rinse and repeat, you know, for each of these posts of light. The finished helipad may well have more lights than this. It's pretty well done right now, but, well, we'll see. The final clip is going to be the completed project. But so here's the lights, and I have the power grid wired up, the independent generator down there, and they're blinking just exactly like they should be. So guys, this was... I'm sorry, PlayStation cut me off again. Guys, this is the end of this section, and the next thing we'll see is a completed project. I hope you enjoy it, because I think it looks pretty darn good, and I will show you what it looks like at night and during the day. It's a real thing of beauty. Okay, guys, and here is the finished product at night. It came out looking pretty good. I gotta say, I'm proud. It's better than I'd even hoped for. Having replaced this wooden foundation with concrete, and then having the stairs come off in a circular fashion off of that circular tower, I didn't even think that was possible. That was something I just kind of figured out along the way. Let's go up here and see what it looks like from the pad itself, and I will explain some stuff here. I had some issues with lighting. having this power grid so close to that power grid, there seems to be a bug where certain lights will get linked with other ones, no matter how far apart they are. I actually had a problem with that. I did have these lights here went down two letters further. They used to go down to here, but I had a problem with those lights were linking with these. No matter where I moved the conduit or what I did, they were linked. I had to delete them. I had the same problem with some lights in here. I will replace this with oil lights. I don't have that problem. It was linking with this light here. And it was a matter of no matter where I moved the conduit, no matter where I moved the light, even saving, reloading, redoing the light, they were linked. Whatever. Okay, so the suspension bridge thing, I think it worked out great. It's a nice, beautiful effect. It's definitely something I'm going to be using more and more and more. Awesome, awesome idea. I was restricted on what lights I could use to actually light this pad, because as I'm sure you know, these neon lights don't actually really provide any light, so I needed some lights out of here. I was restricted by what I could use because of a bug I mentioned back in episode 6 that does not allow you to use certain lights in certain settlements. And me, I'm really restricted by what lights I can use here in Spectacle Island, so that's okay. These work fine. I don't like that they have wires going back to the main building, because it kind of interferes with the aesthetic of my suspension bridge here. I didn't want other wires, but I can't build oil street lamps. They don't illuminate in my settlement. I'll show you exactly what I mean. They're under decorations. Yeah, miscellaneous. There. Say they light up, but they don't actually produce light. It's really annoying, because I love those. So, here's my helipad. Everything's pretty uniform, pretty nice. I am really happy. This turned out great, guys. Use anything, you know, I hope you guys picked up some cool tricks to use here, because I know I figured out half the shit just doing this all day today. My fast travel target is over here. That's why I call it my helipad, because the vertebrates will come and land here. Since this is in the corner of the map, they really only come from one direction. I say that's important because vertebrates, they tend to land their nose on the fast travel target, and since I'm in the corner of the map, they kind of only come from one direction, and so that usually drops me off right here. And of course, if I just fast travel here, I land right here on my helipad, so it all works out great. Guys, I hope you enjoyed this instructional video. I hope I could, you know, show you some new tricks, and if you guys have ways to improve the things I've done, please share them with me. Let's have one more look at my helipad. Guys, it's really handsome, I think. It was well worth spending the hours that I did building it. Like this video if you like my helipad. Subscribe, because I'm always uploading more cool content like this. I'm Darkdally. I will catch you guys later.